My art is a reflection of my love of nature. It is a love song to our planet. I am endlessly fascinated by the connections between organisms, the intricacies of ecosystems, and the complexity of nature, its resilience and its beauty. I love to walk into a forest or jungle and observe the bloom of life on every surface, be it a mangrove in the Brazilian Amazon, or a mossy forest bed here in Germany. I create immersive installations so that others can join me in being moved by the beauty of our planet. We are biologically still the same species that fell asleep under starry skies, attuned to the sounds of birds, insects, and frogs. Our nervous systems are hardwired to connect to nature, and biodiversity tells us there is abundance. We have lost our way, but beneath the noise of our modern lives, we know we are all connected and we need the planet more than she could ever need us. We are part of these ecosystems. The loss of connection to our home is the source of so much of our suffering and the cause of the ecological destruction that is threatening our very existence. The situation is dire. Humanity has wiped out 68% of all biodiversity in just the last 50 years. The benevolent nature of our planet is being altered in frightening ways, and the future facing us is one of droughts, floods, storms, disease, and ultimately a planet that is uninhabitable for us and our children. We don't need to look to the future to see climate change. It is here, ravaging our forests, flooding our cities, and destroying our communities. Its effects felt most strongly by the poor and vulnerable, those who have done the least to contribute to the problem. This will all, if we don't act urgently and immediately, happen within our lifetimes. We can't look away anymore. 2020 has been hard, but I think our grief is a symptom of our love. Our grief reminds us that we are all connected in our humanity, that one group's suffering impacts us all, and that we are all connected to our shared and finite home, our planet. So what do we do? I suggest we go back to our love of nature, of humanity, of our children, of future generations. Because when we love something deeply, we are compelled to act to save it when it is threatened. We need you, especially right now, at this moment, when scientists predict we only have 9 years for our changes to have a meaningful impact, to move to renewable energy, transform our agriculture and economy, and radically reimagine our relationship to our one and only planet. In 20 years from now, I don't want my art to be a memorial for everything we could have saved. I rather want it to inspire action and change today. So what can you do today? Vote for people who believe in science. Lobby governments and companies to do better. Engage with your friends and family and help them understand our climate and ecological crisis. Follow the money. Consumption in affluent countries is directly tied to the destruction of nature. Educate yourself on the systems that you engage with, for example, bike infrastructure, public transportation, and a clean energy grid. It's our duty to be conscious of what we consume and how it is affecting our planet. Eat local and plant-based foods. For instance, when you eat beef in Europe, chances are it was fed soy, and that contributes directly to deforestation in the Amazon. Travel local and avoid flying. Dream big. Protecting the rights of nature and considering ecocide a crime against humanity can go a long way in creating equitable change and protecting the planet. And finally, visit countusin.org and learn about all the actions you can take. You don't need to be perfect to show up for the planet, but you do need to show up. Together, we can and we will rise to this unprecedented challenge.